Today we're talking about how the federal government is getting into buying organic products with a $12 billion farm aid program. Although I've been to a local farmer's market and that's what, 5 heads of kale? So what's going on? Because if there's one thing America knows how to do, it's produce and sell food at suspiciously cheap prices. I'm talking so cheap, we're actually exporting this stuff to India, Africa, Latin America, and China. Places that aren't exactly known for their expensive labor and locally made products. In a place where you can buy 3 Rolexes for the amount we pay for 1 tomato on the vine. I mean, come on, you still have to pick the thing yourself. We're actually exporting to them. So yeah, we're pretty good at exporting agriculture. What's the problem?
China's strategy seems to hit President Trump where his base can feel it, in the farm belt. China has targeted some lesser-known grain crops for weeks, but now is raising the stakes, threatening U.S. soybean farmers who sell a third of their crop to China.
They're no longer buying our soybeans? Oh no! Well, that's actually not great, considering the export of these beans to China alone makes up about 1% of America's total exports. And good luck passing off an additional $14 billion worth of soybeans domestically. That's a whole lot of, I'll have the vegetarian option. Before I go any deeper, I actually had a pretty big misconception when it came to American exports. Because everything I've told you so far is probably leading you to believe that we're sending food internationally faster than people can eat it. It's actually a lot less dramatic, with agriculture making up about 5% of our exports. And if you're missing 5%, you can still get a solid A. Are Chinese exports different? Are we the main providers of food for 3 billion people? Probably not, because if they relied on us for food, this would have ended a lot quicker. Anyways, no, because it actually makes up only about 13% of exports to China. Although, man, do they love their soy! That's our single largest export to them. That one super specific crop somehow beat out cars. Yeah, you know, all cars. Just the entire industry. So why target farmers? I mean, I know China has a history of government policy making food inaccessible to their citizens, but I thought they outgrew that in the 80s.
Well, you know, agriculture is 2% of our GDP. So it's not like they're targeting the biggest part of our economy. But as you say, it's a political decision. They're targeting states that supported President Trump.
They're going after states that supported Donald Trump, and China's being very strategic with its tariffs and trying to cause more Republican unemployment than the deep state and liberals on Twitter combined. So what is the Donald gonna do about it? Well, as we said at the top,
recently they announced a $12 billion package of emergency aid for farmers hurt by Trump's escalating trade war.
$12 billion. That's a pretty large chunk of change to keep red states in the green. But what does that mean? Because I've gotten pretty desensitized here in that the government's throwing a few billion dollars here, $20 billion there, no big deal. Heck, if Wolf Blitzer reported that America was sending $15 billion in paper money to Puerto Rico to help dab things off, I might not even blink. So what is $12 billion? Well, that would about double the food and agricultural budget per year, or be about one-third what we spend on the categories of social security, unemployment, and labor, as well as science. So that's not an insignificant price. But when it comes to the continued existence of our agricultural sector, I'm sure we can move a few numbers around here and there, you know, raise a few taxes.
The next phase of tax reform, House Ways and Means Committee Chairman Kevin Brady laid out a new timeline for a vote on more tax cuts.
Or don't. Maybe start praying and hope we pick the right God. Or, I don't know, adopt the soybean as our new currency. Yeah, that was reported less than a week ago, so buckle up, because forget red China, America's gonna be more in the red soon. Alright, so what is this plan with the $12 billion? Well, buy agricultural products, of course. Oh, if only it were that simple. But then we wouldn't have an episode. Well, there are two parts to this plan. First, the USDA will provide direct payments to producers of soybeans, sorghum, corn, wheat, dairy, and hogs to help them cover their losses and find new markets for their goods. So we're covering agricultural losses and then telling them to sell their products elsewhere. So get ready, Africa, because I have a feeling you're about to get some great deals on soybeans. You can't sell them domestically, or else it'll drive down the price of all domestic soybeans, to the point where millennials might actually stop complaining for one crop cycle. So the plan is to just kind of discreetly dump it into a foreign country, use it to make a fuel of some sort, or if all else fails, just burn it. So anyways, anything to keep the people from eating this food. Government logic at its finest. This is the majority of the program being described as
a new temporary $12 billion program is set to launch around Labor Day, meant to offset the estimated $11 billion in losses farmers face. The goal of this one-time aid package? To tide farmers over until the U.S. can negotiate better trade deals with other countries.
The other part of this program is the department will also purchase surpluses of fruits, nuts, rice, legumes, beef, pork, and milk for distribution to food banks and other nutrition programs. Well, that's more like it. And don't worry if you think I'm about to tell you why you should hate this program, because it actually sounds like one of the best things we could do with this excess. The reason we can do it with these products and not others is, well, a combination of China not ordering much of that product, or the products being so widely demanded that putting a little more of it into circulation won't really affect the supply. It's like worrying that Apple made 10 extra iPhone X's and that'll tank the smartphone market. Nah, just sell them, someone's gonna buy it for $10,000. If, on the other hand, Apple accidentally made an additional $14 billion worth of limited edition signed MacBooks, well, sorry, but you're gonna have to get out your shovel and bury those deep, or else that price is plummeting. So now that we know what's happening, let's actually hear from the politicians.
Nebraska Republican Senator Ben Sasse is a frequent Trump critic and represents many farmers taking the brunt of the impact.
What the administration is offering them instead is $12 billion of gold-plated crutches. That's not what anybody wants.
Sasse is among a growing list of Republicans rejecting the president's trade policies.
Now, I'm in New York, so I'm not going to get on a soapbox and say, I speak for the Midwest farmers. Considering the only people who grow crops out here, we'll just leave it at, they're not exactly USDA approved. Representatives of Midwest districts do not seem too pleased with the situation though, with Tennessee Republican Senator Bob Corker saying, they put in place a policy that requires our farmers to go on welfare. And, you know, it's a ridiculous policy that just needs to be reversed. Credit where credit's due, it is easy to hate welfare when some imaginary undeserving person's getting it. But when you're the one getting it and at the same time speaking out against it, well, you, sir, really believe in what you're saying. And I hope the candidate who beats you because of that has half the integrity you do. The big complaint here is that they've been telling Trump repeatedly not to do these tariffs. And now he started a trade war and their industry is hurting badly. And the solution? Pay them to produce food for any purpose besides domestic consumption. And that'll just boost morale right through the stratosphere. Kansas Senator Jerry Moran pointed out even more contentious issues. And nice background, by the way. What'd you do, crash your kid's photo day? He said, what happens when other countries gain our markets? Can you do $12 billion regularly? How long does this take? Well, don't worry, this shouldn't take too long. I mean, we're the only country capable of making soybeans, so they have to come to the table soon.
Brazil is already exporting more metric tons of soybeans to China than we are.
Brazil is their biggest importer. They've got the most of the Brazilian soy, but for us, we need them to buy our soybeans, correct? So where do you see this going? Because right now, we've got soy prices moving higher, the beans themselves up more than 2%.
Okay, we can fix this. Maybe if we just shut down the government and turn it on again. Have you tried that? Nope. It turns out that every nation that had the technology to go from hunter to hunter-gatherer has the ability to make soybeans, and China's buying them all internationally from other sources. So yeah, how is this gonna work for soybean farmers? Because in April, China canceled a 62,500-ton order and haven't touched a supply since. And I'm pretty sure they didn't suddenly cut soy out of their diet. Now, here's a kind of weird thing that I noticed. China's already running a maximum production of soybeans, and they're importing it from other countries. Basically, they're not benefiting in any way from this. No new local jobs. In fact, they're making the price of soy higher for themselves. They're literally just doing this to mess with us, which shouldn't make negotiating with them a lot of fun, because we just found a bigger troll than the Donald. Not everyone is being so down on this plan, though.
Agriculture Secretary Sonny Perdue said Tuesday the emergency aid package will help mitigate losses incurred by what he called illegal tariffs on American agriculture exports.
First, they're illegal tariffs? There's an elephant in the room if I've ever seen one. So, according to us, their tariffs are illegal while ours are legal. Did Sonny Perdue bump his head before making that statement? No. The US used somewhat obscure domestic trade law to justify the tariffs. So, in our eyes, they're illegal. Where China and other countries are saying, no, your tariffs are illegal, so we can put up our own against you. So yeah, it's just a fight in the WTO right now where we're suing everybody and everybody's suing us. Although, it is helping with domestic employment because we need more lawyers ASAP. So, back to Sonny Perdue, because he likes this $12 billion aid plan. Although, he wrote it, so it's kind of hard for him to be against it. He described it as a short-term solution to allow President Trump the time to work on long-term trade deals to benefit agriculture and the entire US economy. Right now, the administration is saying that this is a temporary measure until we negotiate a great trade deal. And heck yeah, I love great trade deals. The problem is...
Well, the absence of any sort of high-level dialogue is an indication that the impasse could go on for a bit. There has been some discussions at much lower levels, but nothing in the way of any negotiations to bring this to an end.
Again, based on my research with Trump, it seems that this administration is really good at coming up with deals to benefit America. The problem is getting the other side to take our phone calls. So, this could be a temporary negotiating tactic that could end tomorrow and lead to potentially higher employment and a better trade deal. But I'd hold off planting my next crop of soybeans. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello, YouTube. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan comedy news, remember to subscribe by clicking this floating logo to the right of my head. Or do it the old-fashioned way by clicking the subscribe button below. I did recently do a profile piece on Sonny Perdue about 2 weeks ago, although in Trump years that's about a decade, and you can watch it by clicking here. Remember to give me a thumbs up, and as always, thank you for watching!